Well, hello and welcome back to the channel. I'm Dave.
I'm Jill.
And this is Vandromeda's Travels. Davey May. Well, as you might have seen, we've got Vandromeda back, haven't we?
We have.
And then Jill came up with this brilliant idea that I never would have thought of. Cleaning it out.
Well, no. That's not your cup of tea, is it?
Not my cup of coffee or my glass of gin. No. So, we've had a bit clean out, and while we've had a bit clean out, we've had a bit think about what we've found. Have a look. What are you doing, Mrs. Dawn?
Cleaning.
What are you cleaning, Mrs. Dawn?
The bathroom.
You're not just looking at yourself and thinking how beautiful you are.
Hardly.
I would give you a hand, but there's only enough room for one in there. Uh-huh. However, people, look, look, look. The door fastens. Not coming away. Doesn't match up with this one, like. But never mind. There's a small gap. But it could be worse. The hoving, though, is still not fixed. If I lift the lid up, as you can see, it only just slightest bit thing and it comes down. Yes.
They've ordered a new one though.
See again?
They've ordered a new lid because the spring's gone.
Yes, the hinge spring thing, whatever it is gone. It has. Spring clean. All good. If you have a problem with these things here, opening and closing, there's a little knoblet that just pushes out. You may be able to see it catching just there. And when you open it right up, that clicks out. Now if you listen, you just hear it click in. It's a tiny little wee click to click it in, and you might find that it sticks. And that would be the very, very last thing you want, is for it to stick. So the easy answer is a little bit of WD-40, very small amount, just squirted through one of these holes, whichever one happens to be the highest up there would be fine. Little bit of WD-40 or a very thin lubricant, and then your window will mount. But you've got to listen for that click. And it's tiny, tiny little click. And then it's in, and then just push it up to drop it down. Good stuff. I see you've got a Hoover in your hand.
Uh-huh.
Question. No carpet or carpet? What do you think?
I think we need a bit of both. I'm not bothered about the carpet on the way in, but the carpet at the side of the bed and the carpet where we sit, I think is a good idea.
So the bit where you stood?
Uh-huh, carpet.
Carpet.
The bit where you're sat, carpet. The bit in the middle, not so sure.
What's in the thing there? Is that the water?
water tank. Uh-huh. State of that.
Oh, yeah. The other one is where you can put stuff.
Oh, the cubby hole for contraband. Being a bloke, so that the other blokes in the world know, is it easier to hoover bare wood, like where your feet are, or carpet?
You're asking the men?
No, I'm asking you, so that the men know.
Well, does it make much difference to the men?
Well, I just thought I'd ask.
I don't know, as I say, I need to clean it and then put some down and see how it goes. Okay?
Alright.
Off to the bathroom.
Yeah?
I'm off to the bathroom.
Get one for me. Yes. The door's done, but it still doesn't match. That means, to me, that this is the door under the kitchen sink. It's never matched, has it?
No.
It's never been put upright.
No.
Alongside of that, the wobbly bit of plastic along the side of the bed that keeps the mattress away from the wall, we discovered that's held in by...
Well, it should have been five screws.
Should have been five screws, but it was four.
Four. Or was it three?
Well, it was three, really, because one of them...
One of them wasn't attached to anything.
No, it was screwed into the wall, which I laughingly call it screwed in and laughingly call it a wall, but it wasn't attaching the thing. It was the other side of the bit of wobbly plastic that lets the heat up. I think that's what it's for.
Let air circulate.
So Jill decided...
Oh yes, in my wisdom, I'll just get a screwdriver and just tighten it up a bit.
What happened?
No. Well, I didn't, it's all right. It's not broken.
No,
I haven't broken
it,
anything.
It's still attached.
Just. but it's like screwing into fresh air, isn't it?
It is. The walls, the sides, the panels in these things are a sandwich of some insulation, I know the right word, between two membranes, GRP or aluminium or whatever, on the outside where all the graphics and paints go on, and then the inside where there's what looks like cheap wallpaper goes on. And the membrane on the inside is about as thick as the cheap wallpaper, isn't it?
It appears to be.
And about as effective at holding a screw. Mm. Now, it's eminently possible to drill out the areas where the attachment is going to attach, glue in an attachment for the screw to screw into, and then do it. Have they done that?
No.
No. Just straight into the wall. Child of five could pull it off the wall. It's terrible. And we just keep on finding little bits of things like this that are just shoddy. For instance, the window catch things. There are some that you can get that are really, really positive and very, very simple to use, and you could literally flick it and it would latch. If you flick one of these windows, it doesn't, which is why I've had to go around and lubricate them and finesse them and just twiddle stuff about a bit so that they'll actually stay open on the clicky stops. And how can I put this? I'm fed up with fixing little things. It shouldn't be there. This ought to have been checked perfect out of the factory. Now, just to put everybody's mind at rest about what I mean, I am not blaming Kimberley Caravans. Not even remotely am I blaming Kimberley Caravans. They have done fabulously by us. Handover was good. They spotted the first fault and said it needed to be done. And that was the solar charger unit, which is in the stupid place above the kitchen. They spotted that because we wouldn't have known what we were looking for, and said, yeah, that needs to be done. 8 months later, it's been done. That, again, not their fault, because Swift hasn't been there for half the flame in the last 12 months.
And that's not their fault.
That's not their fault. No. But that's now being done. We're still waiting. I mean, the hob thing falling over, the lid on the hob, that should have been picked up. The fact that the door wasn't level should have been picked up. The fact that the shower tray was leaking, was it even tested?
I don't know, but that's not on, really, is it?
No, I don't think there's any excuse for it. This model that we're in is currently called, well, it's called a Bessacarr 584, Swift Bessacarr 584. It's now the Swift Contiki Sport 584. The differences between the two are minimal, and I mean minimal. There's a different fridge that you can control from the control panel above the door. That's it. There are no more differences than that. And it's £68,000 is the price at the minute for a Bessacarr Swift Contiki 584. £68,000. That's a tourist house round here. Might not, and it will be where Swift's based, in North Yorkshire.
Yes.
In fact, you'd probably buy a bloody farm in North Yorkshire for that. So, you know, you're not looking at small money for these things, and I would expect the build quality to be a lot better. So, here's the thing. I'm fed up with it. Don't get us wrong. I love where it gets us. I love what it allows us to do. I think the whole idea of motorhoming is absolutely fabulous. I'm head over heels with it. But this van, for me, with all its niggles now, is a fetid pile of festering dingo kidney.
No, I wouldn't go as far as that. It's not going to stop us from going out.
No, it won't stop us from going out, but and as soon as I can change it,
well,
are.
Yeah, and that's slightly different.
So, I'm looking German. I think I want a Hymer. Specifically, the Masterline 880 with the twin beds at the back, the mahoosive bathroom, washroom, toilet room, lavabogatory area with wardrobes and all the rest of it, and the stilts. I want stilts. Because this thing, even when you've got it levelled on, what do you call them things, the wedges, the chalky things, you're still on the suspension. And it wobbles about like a jelly in a gill when you get into it. As you may be able to see, I decided to test this out and I shot some footage of me getting in. And what I did was to walk the length of the van and then have a reach into the cupboard over the kitchen, and also open the fridge and have a look in the fridge. So you'll be able to see how much it's wobulated. Jill has a reason why it might wobulate a bit more for me than it does for her.
Well, no, I'm you do carry a bit more weight than I do. So
roughly translated into English, that means I'm fat.
No, I wouldn't say that. I didn't say that.
No, you wouldn't, and but you didn't, but I am.
The placement of weight as you move along is greater than when I move along. so it does move. It does move. So I'd be really interested, if you have got...
Self-levelling systems.
Self-levelling system on your motorhome, will you let us know... Does it make it more stable? I've spoken to a lot of people that have got caravans. We don't actually know anyone who has a motorhome with them on, do we?
Not off the top of your head.
But we know caravans, and they say it makes a huge... Well, obviously, they've got to have them. But their caravans don't wobble around like the motorhome does. So I would be interested. It is something that I think we're going to get, but, you know... Your opinions will be gratefully
received
and added to our research.
And faithfully applied. Gratefully received and faithfully applied, yes. Yeah. I will say, however, if anybody suggests 4 bottle jacks and some dustbin lids to put them on, no, it's not happening. David is not crawling underneath a flaming motorhome when it's walloping down with water. Because we want to go to, it'll be wet.
Let's just be honest, David is not an engineer. End of story.
I was a sound engineer.
Well, there's a bit difference between a mechanical engineer and a sound engineer.
The fact of the matter is I'm not allowed tools without supervision.
No, and I'm not qualified to supervise.
I'm pleased that. I'm pleased you said that, yes. No, I'm not allowed tools without supervision because I get tools that do things and then I try and do the things that the tools are meant to do. And really, somebody that's got no idea shouldn't do that.
No, they shouldn't.
I'm not a plumber. I'm not a gas technician.
No.
Electrics I can handle. Because I understand electrics and sound and stuff like that, I can handle. Lights, brilliant. But when it comes to anything mechanical, no. I am to mechanical engineering what chocolate is to teapots.
Yes. Absolutely.
So that's about where we are. We're looking at getting a Hymer.
Again, if you've got a Hymer, let us know how you get on with it. I'm not saying that we expect any... further motorhome that we get not to have any niggles, because they all do.
Them do.
Every car does, every house does, whatever you buy.
Except my German-built motorbike.
Except his German.
My BMW has absolutely no problems with it at all. It's perfect. But much like its rider.
If you've got any tips of what to look out for when you're looking at Hymers in particular, please let us know. We do appreciate your comments and your advice.
I will say, on that topic and on the topic of me being not a small boy, it's pointless suggesting a van or a motorhome that doesn't have the ability for a fat lad like me to get into the loo and the shower, which is specifically why I've looked and decided that the Hymer 880 is probably going to be the best bet. The loo, the lavabogatory in this van is superlative. It's brilliant. It's enormous. I've seen smaller ones in houses.
Mm-hmm.
We have. I need a big, wide area. I'm not the fittest of blokes. I'm very much set in my ways, so I need a big wide area, which is why I've been looking so much at the American ones, but I think German's the way to go. It's a lot closer to get to the German factory than it is to try and swim a motorhome or an RV across the Atlantic to where it's made, in Indiana, mostly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, yes. So, yeah, the 880 is where we're going. Hymer, general Hymer quality would be... I'd be interested to hear about that.
Yeah.
And, you know... especially ones if you've got the three lithium ion battery super duper pack with the solars and the 1800 watt inverter, I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to know how good that 1800 watt inverter is. Specifically, can you run a coffee machine on it? Can you run a bean to cup coffee machine on it? Because that, if you could, that'd be me sorted. That would be me done. Yeah. Beer in the fridge, coffee on tap, and the love of my life.
Mm. To cuddle.
I'm so romantic, aren't I?
Yeah.
Shall we call it a day there?
We'll call it a day there.
Can I say to you all, if you've got this far, what the hell are you doing?
Thank you.
If you've got this far, thank you very much for sticking with us. We do appreciate your company. We really do. I thoroughly enjoy doing this. And Jill's learning there, aren't you?
I'm getting there. And I will have my hair done at some time. I know it's a mess. Apologies for that.
No, I think it looks lovely.
Oh, no, I can't be doing with it. Anyway, we'll get there eventually. We'll get sorted.
We will. Yep. So, yes, thank you so much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed it. If you've enjoyed it half as much as we have, then we'll have enjoyed it twice as much as you, won't we?
Absolutely.
We will. Yep. So, until we see you next time, enjoy the roads.
Enjoy the skies.
But most of all, enjoy your lives. See you on the next one. Take care then. Bye-bye.